All right, so anytime I solve a limit question, I'm going to start by summing my limit into the question. If I sum in 1 for x, I'll get root of 1 plus 8, which is 9. A root of 9 is 3. 3 minus 3 is 0. And the bottom, I'll also get 0 because 5 minus 1 is 4. Root of 4 is 2. 2 minus 2 is 0. So I get the indeterminate form of 0 over 0, which means I have to simplify this equation. Anytime you want to simplify a radical equation, you have to rationalize. I'm going to start by rationalizing the bottom. I'm going to multiply the top and bottom by root of 5 minus x plus 2. All you have to do is change the sign outside the square root, and that's going to rationalize it. So the top is going to be exactly the same. And for the bottom, I know this is a difference of squares. I don't have to worry about the middle terms. So I'm just going to do the first and the last term. The first term is just 5 minus x and then minus 4, negative 2 plus 2. The root of something times the root of something is just that term inside. I'm going to simplify this a bit. The top stays exactly the same. And I can combine like terms in the bottom. So this is just going to be 1 minus x. Now, the next thing I want to do is I want to rationalize this term on the top. I'm going to multiply the top and bottom by root of x plus 8 plus 3. So again, I'm going to FOIL out these two brackets, but middle terms don't matter because it's a difference of squares. That's just going to be x plus 8 minus 9. I did this times this and this times that. Second bracket is going to remain exactly the same, no change there. And the bottom is now going to be 1 minus x root x plus 8. Plus 3. Just going to simplify this bracket over here. X minus 1 root 5 minus x plus 2. This one stays the same. Now I can cancel off these two brackets, but since they're the opposites of each other, when I cancel them off, I'm left with a negative 1. So I'm left with lim x approaches 1, negative root 5 minus x plus 2 over root x plus 8 plus 3. Now I can sum in my limit. After your cancellation, you can always sum in your limit. So in this case, I'll get negative root 4 plus 2 over root 9 plus 3, which is just negative. That's going to be 2 plus 2, which is 4. It's going to be 3 plus 3, which is 6. So final answer is just negative 2 over 3.